Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I am Grimwit. This is Miasmata. When last we left off, we were at a mysterious village, clearly newer than what the natives of this land had been doing. This must be another outpost, but I'll be damned if I know which one. We have plenty of time in the day to find out. Yes, it was pointed out to me, like, gosh, episodes and episodes ago, that the pearl blue mushroom is on my list. My recollection is about as good as my sense of direction. Oh yeah, what's up there? My God. This man died of a nosebleed. Well, that's fascinating. Also, yes. That fills up our map nicely. This is Outpost Polaris. Nope, I cannot use these flowers. A pity. There's so many kind of flora around here to explore. Fauna? Wonder what the difference is. Grimwit from the future here. Flora is plants. Fauna is animals. Well, according to this map, further on ahead, there are even more buildings to explore. We're around here, so we've got quite a ways to go. And a few more notes to read. Let's get started. Bamboo. Would you have thought you'd see bamboo on Eden? Whoa! You're neat! Somehow I got off the path by following the path. Pretty typical of me, actually. It's not hard to find my way. All I have to do is keep going forward and avoid trouble. I don't know if he can hear running. Let's find out.
Shh.
Think we lost him. Save for safety's sake. Climb for climbing's sake. Who would want their house this high? What? We know where Dao is. Some kind of boat landing. Also, seriously, game, you're gonna have the buckle clip through? If we ever need to get off the island, we can. Oh, there was a path up there. With carnivorous plant in hand, we continue onwards. That looks interesting. Are those boxes or blocks? How did I miss you? Looks like Sanchez had an unusual encounter with Herbert. He seems to be going more and more crazy as the letters go on. You can form your own theories, but it seems to me like he's the one that's been murdering everybody. Or maybe running from the murderer, and he's the only one that knows. Hard to tell with madness. We'll have to cut through the woods to get to the other side of the peninsula. Good, we don't have any company, but it is awfully quiet. Ah, one of the hazards of having roommates. Sorry if you can hear them. I normally try to edit them out in post, but since I'm doing this so quickly... That's a house. Let's see if I can get down this way. Yeah, I will take another drink of water. You can never have too much water. Good fishing spot. My experience with fishing is limited to when I was 6, and... Oh yeah, Dark Cloud 2. Finally. Let's see what you do. Energy stimulant. I don't really need you. We're very near something that I need to get. And to get it, I need to get down from here. Of course, I can swim. I can always just go around the tip of the peninsula. But would it be right? It might be. Wow, that's a cliff. So I may not even have to do that. Whoa. Danger. Raw danger. At first glance, it looks like it is a platforming section. It certainly feels platformy. When I first played, that's what I thought I had to do, was find some way to climb up this. Well, it's the afternoon. This is the second of an ingredient that we can't get unless we can swim. To be fair, the distance that Robert Hughes can actually swim, you could probably get a hold of this. Even without the muscle emphasis. Let's take our prize home. Oh, this is stupid, but I like being stupid sometimes. This reminds me of a song of my people. It goes something like this. Do 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 do. I really shouldn't sing. The only lab equipment is on the other side of the peninsula. Back over the hills we go. This particular laboratory reminds me of Myst every time. We'll go through the complete ceremony because this is an important plant. And one that I've been waiting for quite a while. It requires an antitoxin, but this creates Agent Y. Seems like we got an antitoxin a long time ago. There it is. Well, my friend, we can finally use you and free up that inventory space. Hope this works. There we go. Good golly. We have 2/3 of the cure now. And of course, it's packed right there where we can reach it if we need to. This means we can almost become completely cured. The night is young. The cure is close. And lights dance above the Arby's while we all pretend to sleep. There's more to explore, of course. In fact, I think probably the best thing to do at this point would be to save, check out this, and then head completely south and see if we can't get back to Camp Draco or my home, Camp Vega. I would accept either of those outcomes. Wrong button. You ever wake up in the middle of the night and you just need a drink of water? You ever wake up in the middle of the night and you feel like you need to fill your canteen? Because the mornings are so gray, I figured it might be a good time to just add a couple of things. Just to add a couple of things. There's still that one camp that I hauled up at that I think I mentioned 2 episodes ago. Well, let's see if we can get to that camp. Obligatory setting fires to feel joy. I can follow the coast, but I'd rather run. We're about here. We want to go here. Maybe we should follow the coast just for a little bit. I'd like to see what that is. Some basic medicine. Whoa. I was not doing that on purpose. Robert Hughes needed to back the hell up. Hello. This had to be a throne room. And it's got such a good view of the entire Bay Area. The camp I want to visit should be right here, on the innermost point of the bay, but I do not see it from here. Well, that's enough of that. Let's go running. This looks familiar. Technically, all we need to do is follow the path and hug the right. And avoid our friend. I'd like to see how long Robert Hughes can run without rest. Okay. Either I found his stopping point, or I just tripped and fell. That is the first time he's tripped in a while, though. We should be right about here. That's not too bad. Fancy. But it doesn't say he's fatigued. Well, time to continue running. We'll call this a stress test. This might have been the wrong way after all. I'm going to assume that means he's got a fever. We're close to the campsite. And almost taste it. Bad timing. There's really no place for him to go except straight at us. Well, shit. I guess it was inevitable we'd run into him again. Nope, he sees us. Well, I can think of no better stress test than to run away from danger. Can you? So far, running away from the monster has not ever helped. Swimming away has not helped much either. How now, brown cow? I hear the heartbeat, but I do not see him. Ah, there we go. I think we finally left him behind. Why doesn't he want us to go to this camp? Is it possible that the camp is a symbol of his power? Or is it more likely that I'm just really unlucky? my kingdom for spyglass. Well, I am so very close to the camp I seek, so I'm gonna make a dash for it. And if this doesn't work, bah. Do we have company? We do not. Memory serves right. Should be just down this hill. And there it is. It only took me 3 episodes to get to. I have a log and nothing to light it on fire with. Gotta be some way to light this on fire. Oh man, I've never felt so conflicted. I need to light it on fire. Oh god, oh god. I'm starting to get the shakes from lack of fire. Quick, get rid of it. So I'm gonna go ahead and call it a video here. And, I'll see you guys next week. Stay tranquil, everyone.